It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1579, recorded Thursday, July 14th, 2016. Honey, I shrunk the phone! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, Dick has three more gadgets. I make a spectacle out of my Bluetooth gadget, and Jason has the smallest smartphone in the world, and it's only 50 bucks. All coming up next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
a nerd pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the maestro of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing super, sir. And you?
I am doing fantastic, Phil. You got that alliteration so perfect. Super, sir. Dang it.
Super, sir.
I'm doing great, guy. I'm doing great, Giz Wiz.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I'm trying to work that alliteration like you did. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm doing great. Everything. What's been going on the last week for you?
There were a couple more of those Christmas in July things, so I'm finishing up two shows. Today I'm finishing up the stuff from CES week.
Woo-hoo.
And from Pepcom, and then the next 2 weeks are going to be gadgets that you will be finding for the holidays. So that's going to be fun.
Get a jump on your gift-giving list.
Yeah, exactly. Like. You know, they haven't been in July. I think we talked about it. They haven't been in July because the slick magazines, assuming there are any left,
right,
start putting their Christmas guide issues together in August and September. So they need to know what's new and hot. And it was very funny because I went by one table and the woman said, what is your deadline for Christmas? And I said, 3 days before Christmas.
Yeah, exactly. whenever I can send a tweet, as long as the stores are still open,
yes.
that's my deadline.
You know, the funny thing, though, is this: there's one event where they've arranged it so you actually go back and forth. They sort of make you go by every table, okay? And there are tons of tables where they're selling chocolates. And so I've gotten into saying, nothing against your product. I'm seeking technology. But, Chad, 70% of the time.
Oh, you got to see this.
Yes. Yeah, so you've experienced the same thing.
Of course.
This chocolate is produced by a machine that there are only five. I said, well,
that is hooked up to a computer.
Yes.
I need consumer electronics.
Yes.
That people can go buy. Or there's always, we have an app. Well,
yes.
Whoop-de-doo. I don't care.
An app.
Everyone has an app.
An app doesn't do it. I mean, you got to give them credit, but after a while, it's sort of like every once in a while, someone says, "Oh, I understand," and I just say, "Can I shake your hand?"
Yes, thank you for not wasting either of our time.
Yes, for understanding.
Seriously, yeah, absolutely, yeah. No.
So you know what? With all your gaming, are you doing a show on Pokemon now?
Pokemon Go? No.
Okay.
The thing is, I was never into Pokemon. Pokemon, this is brilliant, by the way, on Pokemon's part. So if you haven't heard of Pokemon Go, it is through Niantic, the company that did Ingress with Google. They're now they're absolutely their own company. And Ingress, you would go around and you would hack pylons in virtual reality. Not virtual reality, but a reality that was on your phone using your screen and everything like that. And now they've teamed up with Pokemon. So now you can go out into the world. You can go to Poke Gyms. You can go to Poke Stops. You can capture Pokemon. And hopefully in the future you can battle your friends. Right now you just battle for control over gyms and stuff like that. like training gyms, like you would go and pump iron at.
Wasn't it 65 million downloads already?
This thing is huge. It is the biggest. So, you know, when I was in elementary school, the Pokemon craze hit, and everyone was getting all the cards, and everyone was freaking out. And so now that the people who were young, way when Pokemon hit, they're all in their 20s and 30s, and it still translates to younger audiences. They are just tapping the market. It's like this bubble of people that have grown up, and now they're all on their smartphones, and they're going out and capturing Pokemon, and reliving the young days, you know,
fresh. It kind of vanished for a while,
It did, yeah. No, absolutely. It was.
And then I'm thinking, Pokemon, what are they talking about?
They keep coming out with games and stuff like that, but it was definitely it's been more under the radar as almost like a mainstream type of thing. Pokemon Go comes out, and there's people walking, because you have to actually be out in the world. You have to go to stops. You have to go to public places in order to go to Pokestops and go to, you know, the gyms and capture them and capture more Pokemon, and you'll get eggs, and these eggs will say you have to walk 3 kilometers before they'll hatch, stuff like that. So there's so many. I've seen people with sunburns and people, you know, walking through strange parks at night, like all for Pokemon Go. Now, for me, what's funny is the craze of Pokemon, I never was really that big into Pokemon. So now that Pokemon Go is out, I don't have the strongest desire to leave my house and experience everything that Pokemon Go. So,
you know, I'm like Alfred E. Newman. I played it on a payphone, and unless there's a Pokemon within 3 feet of that stainless cable.
And you got to carry around so many quarters. It's just
You know, you know it's big when I got an email from Boat US, which is an organization of 500,000 boaters, saying that the Coast Guard is telling people, if you're playing this game and looking for seaborne Pokemons, make sure that you're not at the wheel. I mean, it's bizarre.
Oh, my gosh. Hillary Clinton made the most... I don't know who made Pokemon Go, but they need to make Pokemon go to the polls. I was like, oh my gosh, this is getting way too big. It's getting too big for its own shoes. So yeah, it was, Pokemon Go has taken over, the zeitgeist of, at least America. The funny thing is, I don't know if it's worldwide, actually, off the top of my head. I assume it is. But yeah, it all uses that Niantic data, and the stock of Pokemon, Nintendo, who owns Pokemon, or who licenses Pokemon, has just risen, like, insanely, which is hilarious, because Nintendo forever said, we will never go into apps, we'll never go into software, we're always going to be doing our hardware and games for that hardware. This is one of the most successful, you know, gaming apps out there, and it's one of the first... you know, forays that Nintendo has had into the app marketplace. So good on them for finally embracing another ecosystem other than the Wii and their consoles.
Yes, yes.
So very cool. Yeah, so that's what's kind of happened this last week. I guess let's get into what we're covering
Let's do the show. Okay, so we're going to look at some new products. And the first one is an interesting gift for an idea if you want to give or even get for yourself. An easy-to-use aquarium.
Ooh.
I'll get out of the water. Okay, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. So we're walking through the holiday gift guide show, and we come across Biob. These neat-looking aquariums, well, some of them aquariums, some of them are just filled with wacky stuff. Decor. Oh, decor. Okay. Not, oh, I'm sorry. It's not wacky stuff. It's decor. Okay. And we're going to talk to whatever you want to be. And Leslie here is going to tell us about the halo. Is this the halo?
Yes, this is the Biob Halo 15. And we call it that because it's a 15-liter. But here in the States, it would be 4 U.S. gallons.
4 U.S. gallons.
Oh, that's a lot of water.
And now the advantages of this, because I see bubbles going on and I see the water spotless. And why is that?
Well, we have a true 5-stage filtration process. So essentially the key here is that fish waste will sink down to the bottom, get changed into good material for the fish in the ceramic media, get absorbed into the filter cartridge, and then all you have to do is pop out the filter cartridge every 4 to 6 weeks and do a 30% water change. So it's really simple, and it's easy to use, so you could teach your kids to feed the fish and change the filter. You can have it in a home office. You can have it in a schoolroom.
You know what? Is there a limit to the number of fish one should have in a 4-gallon tank just so the fish have room to move?
Absolutely. The rule is technically about an inch of fish per gallon of water. So you're looking at about 3 to 4 inches of fish in a tank like this.
Oh, okay. And are you meeting that standard? Because,
yes.
Okay, I don't have a ruler, but...
about an inch there, an inch there, and maybe 1.5 inches there.
Oh, you just get
by. Fish are just like
by.
Cloth,
now,
you know.
You know, is this a hinge? So the top open?
Yes, there's a hinge here and a magnetic catch here so that it's easy to close. You have an evaporation lid that keeps the water level as it should be, and the little feed hole here opens and you can feed your fish to that little hole. So it's very easy of access to be able to feed your fish.
And now it seems to be, is it changing colors or am I going a little weird here?
It is changing colors. It is. And it has 16 different colors that it can change, and you have a brightness control as well.
Is that a remote control, or how is that controlled?
Yes. Let me grab the remote.
Okay.
She has misplaced the remote control.
The remote. Okay. It comes with a remote control.
So it comes with a remote control, and you have your 16 different color options and your brightness here. And then the remote is accessed in the front there.
And is the remote using, how far away from the bowl, the fish bowl, can you be with the remote?
You can have, you know, you can have it on your coffee table, sitting on the couch, or, you know, standing a little bit
15
away.
Feet or so?
Yeah, about so.
Okay, and the retail price of this?
The base model is $99.
Okay, so are we looking at the base model?
Yes, you are, absolutely.
And then the optional, are these optional in as much as, what do they do that the base model doesn't do?
Well, your base model handle is ready to go. You just put it together, add water and fish. It's just your decor options.
Oh, I see. You can order it and put it together and just have, like, Dennis, show that over there. So if you just want to have it as an ornament and have it changing colors.
The sculptures, the sea fans. Feng Shui Pebbles.
The Biorb Halo. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I wish I had a filter that I could change. Bye.
That's, you know, for someone who, A, has never had fish in their life, we've never had an aquarium, never dealt with fish. I always thought, God, that seems like a lot of work. For fish. And so this seems like a lot less work for fish,
yes,
although an expensive orb.
My father had fish, and once a month or once a week, I found out we had to get a little fish net. You had to get a big bucket of water. You had to run around the thing and catch the fish in a little net, transfer them to the bucket, and then scrub the sides of the aquarium. And it was... It took like an hour to do this thing. So this seems like a real easy way to do it and a clever way. I'm not sure how the fish feel about the changing colors. Maybe they don't care, but it's an easy way to do it. And also it kind of looks nice just if you want to have a desk ornament. You can put all those other rocks and things in there. And I assume you could just buy an empty bowl and find stuff in your local woods to fill it with instead of spending money to buy their stuff.
Right, exactly. The decor. Yeah, it seems you know, the decor isn't needed as much. So, yeah. I think that it looks really neat. Not only did, so it seems like it's this, you know, it's $100. I actually don't know what a normal fish tank would cost.
Boy, I have no idea either.
Yeah, maybe we should look that up real fast. Yeah. But it seems like what you're getting is you're getting the LEDs, you're getting the fact that it's a really cool orb. It looks like you're getting of course the easy change filter, that
right.
sort of thing. Right.
You get the pump system, you get the water conditioner, the filter cartridge, ceramic media, which I assume is pebbles for the bottom. The air pump that makes those bubbles. And someone in the chat room said, where do you buy the fish ruler?
Yeah, I've never heard of fish described in...
neither did I, but it's kind of interesting because I did wonder, and I sort of just said it as like a joke, but there is an official answer. It's like a foot per, I even forgot now, what was it, a foot per gallon or a foot per quart?
Inch per gallon, I think it
per
was.
Per gallon, yeah, something like that. And that was a 4-gallon orb.
Yeah.
And also it's acrylic, so it's 10 times stronger than glass. So the other thing you don't have to worry about is accidentally cracking the glass.
So it looks like we got some, I'm looking at some aquariums right now. We have some small ones. This is a 3-gallon aquarium. That's for $35 on Prime. Of course, it doesn't have all the features of the one that we just saw. So it doesn't look like these are huge. And they're also, you know, pretty highly priced, $50 and that sort of thing. So a designer aquarium with LEDs and
remote control.
Remote control and motor and filter. See this one, oh man, like that one is, looks like it has a lot of those types of features, and that one's $200, so, $260, so. It sounds like it's a pretty good idea.
A reasonable price for a kind of, a different kind of gadget.
Perfect! Okay, moving on.
Okay, now moving on, I passed to radios. Normally I don't do Bluetooth radios, but when the woman said one of these two radios can start your car, I thought I better get more, and this is it.
And here we go.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. If you're looking for portables that are rugged, we have come to the right place. These are two Dreamwave radios and chargers, and this is the Tremma. And the Tremma is, we're going to talk to Kelsey here. So the Tremma, you know how many watts of power we have?
It's got 50 watts of power.
50 watts of power. And I'm looking at some of the, so it's waterproof?
Yes, it's waterproof, dustproof, snowproof, sandproof. It's got an IPX5 rating.
Okay, and it has NFC, near field communication. What kind of music is built in? I know you can stream music. It's Bluetooth.
Yeah.
And NFC. Is there a card reader in here or an SD card that you can...
No.
No, okay. So the music that we're hearing is coming from...
It's coming from my cellular device right here, so it's whatever you would like to play.
Okay, mm-hmm. Very good. And now there's another version of it up here, and what's unique about this is... Well, you tell us the features.
Okay, so this speaker is really great. It can actually jumpstart your car. It comes with a USB port as well, right here, so you can charge your devices, and an aux port as well. And then on this side, we actually have a flashlight, which has 110 lumens, so you can see up to 400 feet in front of you if need be.
And the sky is the big one.
Yep.
So what does he weigh?
He's 15 pounds, and he retails for $300.
$300, and the slightly smaller one?
So we've got the Survivor here. It's about 10 pounds, and this one retails for $280.
Okay, and just the Survivor has the built-in battery charger to jumpstart a car. Are they both out now?
Yes, they both are. You can purchase them at dreamwaveus.com, amazon.com, or Cabela's.
Okay, there you go. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
A good survival radio is always needed. Yes. And that one looks fancy.
Yeah, and I looked on Amazon. It got excellent reviews, especially for audio performance. So that made me think they play them low at these events. They ask if you want to hear them loud, but I don't want to disturb anybody else.
Right, exactly.
It was a table nearby. It seems very well built. I've never seen a radio where they've integrated the 12-volt system to jumpstart a car. And the big guy has a 20,800 milliamp battery in it.
Yikes.
Yeah, I know. So that is a big guy and has two drivers, two passive speakers, two tweeters. And strangely enough, the list price on that one is $299, basically $300. On Amazon, it's $310 for some reason. the other radio on the manufacturer's website is $280, and that one is $255 on Amazon. So, as we always say, shop around.
Yeah, make sure you're looking around before.
Yeah, exactly. But they're very well built, and just go up to the ratings thing there on that one.
This one, you would be the first to rate this.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Check the other one. Maybe it was.
What was that?
It's called the Tremor.
Dreamware apparently makes. Lots of Dreamware, obviously.
Right. Dreamwave.
Dreamwave, apparently. Oh, yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
I read
Dreamwave Tremor. Oh, I thought I put the link to it there, but I guess I did.
You may have. Here, one second. I got the trimmer right here. Let me grab it and see it on Amazon. Sorry about the...
No problem.
So... now, do you think you would spend that much on...
You know what? I probably would. I would be more likely to buy the one that had the battery jumper thing built in.
Right. This one has 6 customer reviews. All are 5 stars. So this
okay.
is the trimmer. Breaks down to all 5 stars.
I know. I'd like to see a bigger number
of
reviews.
Yeah, exactly. Than just 6.
Just 5. Yeah. But they're probably new in the marketplace, which is why the other one doesn't have any ratings yet. But they're certainly, I picked one up, I held it. They're certainly well-built feeling.
They look very rugged.
They do.
Very rugged.
Industrial strength boom boxes.
Interesting.
Yeah. So they're at Dreamwave US. And if you type in, as I accidentally did, Dreamwave USA, you get steered to another website.
Cool. Moving on.
Our final device is an engineering marvel for coffee makers. And actually, the guy who's going to talk about it, Sam Ash, I've known for years. He's a PR guy. He's very funny. It was good to see him at the show describing this new coffee maker. So let's take a look. Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're at Gourmia, and I found a very interesting coffee maker here. So if you were to guess how many different kinds of pod coffees there are, we see 3 here, but Sam Ash, who's been known to make up things, but...
Nice hair, Dick. I like what you've done with it.
Yeah. All right, so Sam, how many different pods can this particular coffee maker handle?
Dick, we call this Sybil because it has multiple personalities when it comes to coffee. We're up to 6, but there's over a dozen different formats worldwide in terms of different pods. K-cups, then you have your capsules. This can handle everything. It even has a adapter. You can handle fresh ground coffee, so you can have your own little version. The beauty of it is it's one footprint. It's one unit. So if you live in a house like mine where some of your kids like espresso and your wife likes decaf and you like high octane the way I do, and you'd have to have a Keurig machine and an espresso machine and a Lavazza machine because my son likes Italian coffee because it's cheaper than going to Italy, now you'd only need 3 footprints. All you need is our all-in-one Gourmia coffee maker. If you take a look over here, it's right now programmed for, it just made an espresso. Now, the key over here is espresso has a higher water pressure to get a more authentic experience. This doesn't. It's not just about putting in the right pod or the right capsule. It's about adjusting the water pressure, the water temperature to taste. Every part of the experience is as authentic as if you had a dedicated machine. And that's really what sets us apart, because as a brand, Gourmet is about gourmet enablers. Everybody likes food. Everybody has their own preferences, their own taste. People are eating better, fresher. They want it the way they want it. We let you recreate the experience with a minimum amount. I think the technical word is potchke, but we let you recreate the experience the way you want it. The machine is going to be out before the holidays, hopefully, somewhere in the $299 to $399 range, depending on the configuration, because you'll be able to buy it with different amount of modules and pods depending on your druthers.
Tell me the name of the actual device again.
I have to go to my cheat sheet. I apologize, boys and girls. The device is the Gourmet GC5000, the multi-coffee maker, multi-coffee pod and capsule maker.
Okay, there we go. The coffee's being made as we speak, and now we went from making espresso to making a K-cup. Dick DeBartolo, Man's Man Destroyer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
I love you, Dick. That guy. Well, that's probably the best PR guy I think I've ever seen.
Yeah, he's very funny. Next week I'll show you a tea maker that they came up with. I mean, it's really an engineering marvel.
Yeah.
How can you possibly
do that? Can you imagine the moving parts?
Yes. Well, there are actually cartridge changers that you slide in.
Oh, yeah.
So it's going to be $299. I think it does six different varieties of pods and cups and things, and then it'll be more expensive if you want to go to the ultimate. Is that you can use 12 different formats from 12 different companies. Now, it is on the pricey side. On the other hand, if you bought a K-cup machine and an espresso maker, you're already up to around $300. And so it's a very small footprint. It seems to be very well engineered. I mean, while I was standing there, they went from making an espresso, which, as Sam pointed out, takes a lot of pressure to make a little bit of coffee really, really thick with flavor. And then they slid a little thing out, and it became a K-cup machine. So
yeah, so if you want the coffee maker that does
everything, and you don't have a lot, you have more money than counter space.
Exactly. You live in a small New York apartment.
Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
There you go.
Gourmet.
You want Gourmet GC5000, and it will be out by the holidays.
Yes, you're hearing it here first. Anything written or recorded about it.
Exactly. It's not on their website. I looked and it's not there. So yep. You heard it here first. Well, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, that brings us to the part of the show that cannot be avoided. So stop the emails.
Stop complaining about it.
It's part of the show. It's in his contract. And that cannot be changed. And I'm talking about Chad's.
You might want it at Chad's crappy corner. Get it.
Okay, so we're on Bluetooth month. So yep. When you think of Bluetooth,
The patrons picked that out.
There's only really one thing you think about, and that is sunglasses. So we have the Wowfast Bluetooth sunglasses. How do you think I look?
Diggity. Wow.
Yeah, I know.
Wow, they match your hair.
Yeah, I got them in red. They come in a few different colors. You can see. Now, I right now have in my own headphones for the show. We can pull one of those out. And you can see that there's headphones.
You look like government security.
Yeah, look at me.
Agent. You know? Wow.
If I need to see something, you know, like, oh, there's that. This tent is a little bit too dark. There we go. Yeah, let's look at that right there.
Oh.
Ah, Much, much better now. Now I look cool, I know. and then of course, it's Bluetooth. So the things that you're going to be able to do with this headset are take and receive and place calls. You're also going to be able to listen to your music. And then on the top of this side, you have back, forward, pause, play, buttons. That's just pause and play is a single button. So you have three buttons, forward, back, and pause and play. Now, one weird thing is that the back button is actually the forwardmost button. So this is the back button. But I would think in my mind, because it's forward on my face, it would be the go forward button. And if I wanted to hit back on a song, I would hit the back button. Just a little bit weird. It kind of makes sense if you think about it by looking. If you're looking at there's it's engraved here on the side. Here, I'll show you that. Is that on this bottom piece, this is the back button because this is pause and play. So you're going back.
That is weird.
A little bit confusing. So it comes with quite a lot of features, in my opinion. The headphones have a really nice. It's a nice sort of like action, so that you can have it set exactly.
Is that spring loaded, or are you pushing it back?
I'm pushing it back and forth.
Okay.
It'll stay wherever I want it to.
Oh, that's good.
The headphones also have a swivel, so if for wherever you know your ear lands, it also comes with, of course, a USB charger. It comes with a screwdriver, which I'll explain why it comes with a screwdriver in just a second. Actually, I'll explain it right now. The reason it comes with the screwdriver is because it comes with three different sets of lenses. So right now it's set with the black tinted lenses. It comes with brown tinted, yellow tinted, and clear lenses as well. And you would remove them by pushing forward on here, and your screws are right there to change the lenses.
Oh, okay.
So, just to give you a little idea of what they sound like, I will start off by saying they don't sound as good as the Bluetooth gloves on. Oh, they also come with a microfiber cloth. They don't sound as good as the Bluetooth gloves. I'm just going to say that right off the beginning. And also, there is a slight delay in this video between the microphone and the video. And that is because I have to call a phone in order to hear it. So there's a phone delay on the video we're about ready to watch. But here is what it sounds like.
Hey, Dickie D. How do you like my fancy sunglasses? Hi, Kitty. This is what the audio sounds like on the sunglasses. And if the audio and video is a little bit delayed, it's because I have to go through another call. I have to go through a phone call in order for you to hear the audio. So hopefully it's not too badly synced up. And that's what the audio sounds like.
So not as good, in my opinion, as the gloves, but still you can hear me.
Yeah.
It was a little bit roomy, I would think, a little bit kind of stale. I don't know.
And does it stop
audio.
The music? It will.
So
in?
On top of that, there are audio cues. So when you pair and unpair, as long as they're resting on your head and you can, you have these so that you can actually hear, it'll tell you, paired with device. Whenever a phone call ends, it will say in English, call has ended. So the Bluetooth is pretty user friendly, on top of that. I just had to hold down the play button for a few seconds, to put it into pair mode. The thing that I actually really liked these, sunglasses for was music. Taking a phone call wasn't all that great because the microphone issues, but music sounds great. And so I could really see that if you were going to go running, this would be fantastic because it's light enough that you could run with this on your head. And just walking around, you don't have the cable, you don't have anything resting on the back of your neck, you don't have any of those issues just because you are wearing sunglasses, basically.
No,
so
yeah.
I found that with music, it was really, 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 really nice. Now, the only weird thing about these glass, oh, well, there's a few weird things, but the one thing that I want to point out is that for some reason I had heard not only on, anyway, I thought that these could take pictures. And that comes from the Amazon page, where there's a little guy in the background and he's holding a camera. And I swear that this guy back here holding this camera.
Oh yeah,
back
I
here,
see. Yeah, I'm on that. I'm on
there
our
he
page
is. See,
now.
He's holding a little camera. I would think that this would be able to take photos. By the way, there's lots of different colors.
Well, wait a minute. I'm just looking at the price.
$16. It's
and
$17.
And you wanted to have a camera too?
I don't know. That's the only confusing bit is that it really looks like. It comes with a camera, and first, I feel like I read somewhere that it came with a camera. No clue where, if that's true or not. Doesn't look
oh,
like
I,
it's
I
true.
Bet it's not.
Yeah, I didn't think it would. But yeah, you're right. So, this is only $16 and 88 cents. Now, and there's also many different colors. So if you wanted black.
Also, Chad, it got great reviews.
It has fantastic reviews. People love these glasses. I mean, they love them. They absolutely
you know what?
Love
I'm
them.
Gonna buy a pair too.
Yeah, yeah. Other you know, there's some funny quirks. By the way, this is a different model. This this model that costs $20, you can see that the headphones are quite different, and everything about it is quite different. So there are some others in here that are not the model that that I did. But there are three or four colors, silver, blue, red, and black, in the model that I want, that I have. So yeah, so let's just run quickly through the features. $17, flip up shades so that you can look uber cool. You can have different, it comes with four different lenses, replacements, comes with a screwdriver to do that, rechargeable, Bluetooth, takes and sends calls, and you can listen to your music on the go with what I believe is very good audio quality, comes with a pretty nice case as well,
wow.
And a microfiber cloth.
Did I say the play time on one charge?
No, I haven't had enough time to test it myself. Let me see if I can quickly see in the Amazon review how long it
takes. Oh, you know what? Just read the last line of copy there. Made of polarized lenses. Did you see it?
There's too much here. English is all over.
It Thanks has function using- of anti-rays.
Thanks for using our Bluetooth sunglasses. We attached the user manual, which can make you operate the player successfully. Please read the manual carefully before using this product. The user book is subject to update changes without notice. Somehow this is going to magically update without me knowing about it. This manual is for reference only. Please check it carefully. Yeah, no, there's it's probably the best translation that I've read, but
you know what, that is way better than the copy on the website.
Is it? Is the copy on the website bad?
Yeah. I love made of polarized lenses. How do they do that? They take polarized lenses and grind them up and make sunglasses.
Oh yeah, yeah. You make your glasses out of polarized lenses.
I'm getting a pair.
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, so anyway, I think that this is quite a deal for the cost. You get quite a lot. Of course it's not, I mean it's plastic, you know, and that sort of thing, but that is very expected. From these Bluetooth glasses.
You know what the great thing is, that if you forget them in the gym or you break them.
$15.
Yeah.
Exactly. And to be honest, that's the other thing is the lenses. Let's say you scratch them. You got three others. They might not be the perfect color.
You know, cool, Chad. Cool is a yellow lens and a green
lens. There you go. Yeah, you know
that. You know, people will say, "Wow, what is that?"
That's really how you impress all people.
That's how you impress people.
Yeah, is and let's just see just how easy it is to dismantle. And I'm gonna aim for the yellow lenses. There we
polarized
go.
Polarized lens. Yeah, polarized. Okay. PC guy is saying polarized lenses are good because they do cut down glare.
They do. And you can see, like, especially fishing people who fish a lot really like polarized lenses because you can see under the water because of the glare reduction. The sun, the glare from the sun isn't nearly as bad. Okay, so this is about how long it takes to...
And is it one single screw that you took out?
Yep, just one. So there could definitely be a weak point in these glasses right there. But
well, you have that roll of tape, so you don't have to
worry now
about.
I'm ready to go to my very own 3D show. There we go.
Yeah, now that's neat. That's
it looks.
Good.
It's an eye patch, really. It's a
It's a pirate. They have pirates.
Yeah, absolutely.
Pirate sunglasses.
So that's how quick it is to switch out the lenses. So those are they have a weird first name on them. The Wonfast, WONFAST, all one word. Wonfast. Yeah. Bluetooth sunglasses.
Right, and it's copyrighted, so don't try to steal that
it's
name.
It's registered. No. Oh, man, I was going to make a buttload off of that great brand. They've really set a brand for themselves, Wonfast.
Chad.
What?
Chad, go down on that page to the generic... pinhole DVR sunglasses.
Generic pinhole? These are $15. Wait.
Oh, but you know what? You know what, Chad? They're probably not Bluetooth.
Oh, they're not.
They're not.
Well,
okay.
I don't know. Why would you have headphones on your own DVR? I guess.
I guess you're recording sound.
Maybe. Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
That's $15. We need to do a spy month again.
Yeah. If a spy, they'd be perfect for spy month.
Interesting. Interesting. Yeah. I also had a good idea we should do smart home. Oh, this one did not get as many good reviews. This is only at three stars.
Oh, no. Okay. No, I'm staying with the ones you got.
So, those are my Bluetooth sunglasses. I'm really surprised at them this week.
So, this is like one of the best gadgets you've done in a while,
the
right?
Least crappiest gadget for quite a while. Absolutely. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, and you know, if they want to use that, they'll have to pay. If they want to use that as a...
Registered. Registered.
Least crappiest gadget in a long time. OMG Chad, Giz Wiz Show.
Use it as a blurb on their packaging. Yeah. With that, let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
All right, our Gadget Warehouse, you know, that's where we, no matter what it is from a viewer, it goes into the Gadget Warehouse segment. This is not a warehouse gadget, but it's a gadget that I never knew about, and my guess is very few viewers know about the world's smallest cell phone. So let's watch Jason's video.
Good morning, good day, Dick and Chad of the Giz Wiz. I have here is a what they claim is the world's smallest phone by Posh Mobile.
Oh, Posh!
It's so 2.4-inch. I think it's Lollipop. I don't remember. I know it's not the latest one that they have released right now. And they had it in blue, black, and pink, which is more like peach to me than pink. Only reason I picked that color is, well, if it's a color like this, it's less likely to be stolen.
Isn't that great? What and a great
good point.
But the main reason I bought this is because the company claimed this to be the world's smallest phone, which is 2.4 inch, and because of its size, you would have to have really small baby hands to play around with a little keyboard. So if that's an issue, you're best to get a stylus for this kind of thing. And to do a major comparison,
there's that phone.
This phone is not going to be my primary phone. I just bought it because how so unique it is. But here's a size comparison.
Oh my gosh! What phone is that he's using?
He tells us.
That versus a 6.4-inch Sony.
The Sony 6.4.
Oh yeah, 6.4 inches. Oh my gosh! It's tiny!
I wish Sony would announce a 4K version of that phone. But I hope that's enough light. I got it under landscape mode here. Still, I hope that this is enough light.
Perfect, it's great.
Still, I hope so. See.
Very, very, very cool. Bye. Thank you so much, Jason. Wow.
Jason Dorsey. So it's on Amazon. It's $49.
$50. Oh, my God.
It's unlocked, but it's... what are the two systems? You can't use
GSM
it on Verizon.
GSM or... it's GSM. CDMA is the other one.
CDMA, yeah. Okay, so this works on several systems. Oh, there's the peach.
There's
Peach. You can get the... Oh, they call it Dorsey Pink, I think. but what a great idea to have a terrible color phone so that no one takes it.
Is this true? It looks like the other Amazon photos aren't even this phone.
You know what? I don't think they are, Chad, because I'm looking and they make a whole line of phones, Pashtas.
This is the phone.
So this one, which is the world's smallest. Then they make a 7-inch. I'm just looking here. It's a 2.4-inch IPS touchscreen. What?
Interesting. That's wow. I mean, it looks like it's the size of a credit card. Basically.
Listen to the memory. 4 gigabytes of memory, but it takes a micro SD card up to 32 gigabytes.
Gosh, that's very, very, very interesting.
Yeah, you know, I guess like it's like carrying an emergency phone that's the size of your emergency battery.
Exactly. It's smaller than my battery.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, by the way, I'm getting a notification that the reason there is a guy holding a camera in my crappy corner gadget is because it has a way to activate the selfie, you know, because you can hit the thing and the volume up button and it'll take a photo. So it's like if you wanted to use it as a selfie remote, you could do that. Okay.
Oh, okay.
That makes sense. Okay. Why there's a guy holding the camera.
Now how much would you pay?
$16.88. That's how much I would pay. So that's so funny. So going back to Posh Mobile.
Posh Mobile. So if you want the world's smallest phone or the one that Posh Mobile says is the world's smallest phone, don't go to their website because it's $90
expensive
on their website, but seems to be $49.99 on Amazon.
It has KitKat is what it's running.
So KitKat is several generations old, right?
They have an unboxing video. Whoa, that's loud. Oh, my God. They have an unboxing video for their own.
Must be the world's smallest box.
It's the world's shortest unboxing video, too. wow, that is a tiny little itty bitty phone. It looks like a kid's phone. It looks like something that would come out of a cereal box.
No, you know, you're absolutely right. You know, in reality,
look, his thumb is half the size of that screen.
You know what? You probably can't use this without a stylus, right?
That's what I'm wondering. I mean, look at his thumb compared to the screen.
Yes,
it takes up half the screen. Oh my gosh!
You're right.
Well, Jason, that is great. And it sounded like, did he have to re-record because it was in portrait mode? It sounded like he mentioned that it was in landscape, which is perfect. Thank you so much.
Oh, yeah, no, that was great. So, Jason, you will get the current issue of Mad Magazine, one of those 28-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. We're still looking for more videos. I know we have at least one more in-house, but we need more. So make us a video. It can be anything. Like that was a great thing that Jason did, showing us the world's smallest cell phone. Who knew such a thing existed? Who knew you could buy it for $50? And who knew that you probably don't want it except to say, look it, this is the world's smallest phone. So make a little video. Jason's length was perfect, like 2 to 3 minutes. Post it on YouTube and click unlisted, okay? And that way only people with the link will be able to watch it. I mean, you can put it up as public if you want anybody who stumbles by to see it. But if you want to keep it sort of semi-private, click unlisted. Send us the link, and the link goes to mail@gizwiz.tv. And just send us a little email with the link and, you know, just a couple of lines about, you know, like Jason said, I think I found the world's smallest phone. And hopefully you'll see it here on the Giz Wiz show. And if you live in U.S. and Canada or Canada, you get the Mad and the pic and the portrait. If you live outside, we still love your video and we will credit you for the video and do a shout out to you or whoever you want here on the show. So mail@gizwiz.tv.
And thank you guys so much for sending those over. With that, let's jump into the letter.
Here come the letters, those lovely letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters now.
All right, our letter says, hi, Dick and Chad. I remember a year or two ago, there was a running joke on the Giz Wiz about a machine that would record your CDs to vinyl. I even think you guys mocked up a photo of what it would look like. Anyway, it's not a joke anymore. I went to the National Association of Music Merchandisers show in Nashville recently. I saw a lot of gadgets, but among them, I remember the vinyl recorder. It cuts vinyl records one at a time from your digital or analog recordings. Device looks very convoluted. I asked the guy at the booth if it was a prototype. He said sternly, no. Actually, he was very nice, but I was fascinated with this thing. They were demonstrating it at the time. I wish I shot a video of it in operation, but I did snap this photo.
Wow. This looks, you know, very complicated for...
It looks very complicated, and it sure does look like the first go. It looks more like the pancake bot, doesn't it?
It does.
except you make pancakes on out of vinyl. The photo on the website has a very dark background and dramatic lighting, but my photo is what it really looks like.
Interesting. So...
Speaking of their web, oh yeah, yes.
This is their website.
Their website, and it says, you can see. He said they did a very dramatic thing. So he said, read one thing because he said the translations are very highest volume.
Yeah, for strong record players for all kinds of blanks, all accessories.
All accessories. Okay. You can do
no cutter styluses, no problem. Yeah, the translations aren't all that great.
No. Oh, and this shows how it does it.
Yeah. Okay.
there at vinylrecorder.com. But if you've been a Giz Wiz listener for a long time, it turned out that one Giz Wiz show we recorded on an April 1st. And so Leo and I very seriously did Digivina, where you could make your own records. Exactly. And this was Digivina Portable, which was being introduced. So it made your own vinyl records out of the empty bottles you had around the house.
Ah, so okay, so that's why it looks like a McCormick grill.
You take
one of those, you press it in there.
Exactly. Make your record.
There you go. You make
this is what it looks like. And then this was the portable version that was coming along, where you would throw the empty bottles in that big funnel.
Yeah. I like the speeds down there too. You got the
33 and a third speed. Bake.
Yes.
45
apparently
broil.
Digivina 2.0 is coming out. Here's the Kickstarter project. Oh my gosh, we have raised 0.00001 of our $5 goal.
Yeah.
Oh man, that is hilarious. Who made this website?
You know what? I made the website, and then someone sent in some more photos, and I wish I could remember who it was to give them credit. And then I just decided, you know what? For $15 a year, I'll just keep it up, because every once in a while, like tonight, we can.
I'm glad I can print this page.
Refer to it.
There's a print button at the bottom of the page. Like,
good.
You would want to keep this forever. I must print it out.
Yeah, this is from One and One. And actually, at first, I was upset, because it turns out that they are totally redoing how their websites are designed. And it said, you have a One and One website, and it's only good through August. And if you want to keep it past August, we're going to charge you $7 a month or something. However, if you want to go to our new web designer site and redesign a website, you can still have it for free because when you bought your domain name, that was the deal. And you know what? I think they still have it. One and One has an incredible deal. It's $15 to register a domain name. And they give you, I believe it is a 5-page website for free.
How much bandwidth is it? I mean, I assume it's just like, don't go crazy.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But the thing is, I
need a quick one-use website for something.
Yes. And I have a lot of them, you know, fly-by-night products.
Right.
That's where my greeting card is, which is... best holiday wishes from Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medestroiter, and the GizWiz.com. And that turns out to be a website that is 3 characters short of the longest a website can be. So I have like 30 websites that I pay $15 a year to keep up, just because they're silly and they're fun
amazing.
To talk about.
And I mean, I can't tell you how many... sites of local businesses only need 5 pages.
Yes, exactly.
They need, even a restaurant needs a starter page with links to go to their menu, their hours, and their map. And then those are...
And they're done.
I can't tell you how many times...
Dennis has a 5-page website.
Yeah.
I said, Dennis... He said, no, I just like a couple of art samples. I said, this is perfect for you.
Yeah.
You're not going to have pages and pages of art. You just want a demonstration of what your artwork style is and a contact page. So there you go.
That's perfect. Done and done.
Done and done.
Done and done. Okay, well, that is our letter. Thank you so much, Norris, for sending that over. We want to give a big thank you to our patrons over at patreon.com, just like in... the Renaissance, where patrons would help artists create. You are our patrons over at patreon.com. Patreon.com is a website that helps you support your favorite content creators. And we have our site, patreon.com/gizwiz, is where you can help support the show. And we thank you so much. As a reward back, you'll get to choose the upcoming what is it, Crappy Corner, My Crappy Corner, through straw polls, and anything else that we throw your way. So thank you so much to our patrons for supporting the show. You guys really make the show amazing.
And possible.
And
no, every time I see that Patreon thing, I think, you know what? If it wasn't for them, I would be reading a book now or saying, oh, I wish I had a show. But
yeah,
so
I
thank
wish
you.
I could record something right now.
Yeah, thank you for making this possible.
Oh, that's great. Thank you. Don't forget to play What the Heck Is It over at gizwiz.biz. This is what we're trying to guess. What it is, and it is obviously a way to recycle your aluminum cans into trowels. It is for the soda drinking gardener. I know that's what it is, but if you think that you have an idea, there are 12 Mad Magazines available for you if you have the correct answer. If there's more than 12 people, randomly given away. And then double the Mad Magazines, sometimes even more, for funny, hilarious, cute, and ridiculous answers. Try to keep them short, though, under 25 words, if you would. And there is an email for you to send in your guesses to on that site. That's just at gizwiz.biz. Scroll down to the What the Heck Is It banner on the side. And don't forget, while you're there at gizwiz.biz, check out all the show notes. Dick does a great job of writing up articles about each and every one of the products that we talk about. If for some reason, you know, it's been a while and you can't find that, head on over to gizwiz.tv. Gizwiz.tv is where we keep all of our shows. And in there are links back to Dick's articles as well. If you want to watch us live, that's the URL to use, gizwiz.tv. Here we are live right now. There's a chat room which you can join and participate in. There's also links to subscribe on iTunes, RSS, YouTube, and more. So thank you guys so much for subscribing and getting the show delivered by robots to you. And that about wraps it up for this episode of the Giz Wiz. Is there anything else you gotta say or do?
No, yes, except I'll be here.